Hey guys, it's day two of our adventures at Welker Farms here to help them rebuild their two air carts. As you can see, we got the whole gang here except for Nick. We don't know why he's here. He could be still sleeping, but we won't give him too much of a hard time. No, he's probably doing something really important, but we just want to give you an update and say that we really got the two carts in a good situation. We are going to start pulling all the tanks today. We've got one off yesterday, so there it is. And I don't know why we could only get one done, but today they're gonna fly off. And otherwise, we're a little sore, we're a little stiff from yesterday, but we're very high-spirited and really excited to get going on this, right?
Yes. Oh, absolutely, oh, yeah.
Are we gonna have a dirtier or cleaner day today?
Little cleaner, yeah.
Little cleaner, maybe.
As long as I'm not as dirty as this guy was yesterday, yeah. I'll be happy.
All right, what needs to be done is each one of these plastic tanks has a cradle on the bottom. Well, it's like a belly pan, basically. And they got bolts through them. Well, the bolts are just so rusted out, you can't get them off. So they're taking the plasma cutter, cutting off each one of the bolts so we can remove that pan. Now, when they install, after they clean this all up, when they install those stainless steel pans, we'll put those in the cart first, then we'll take each one of these tanks and put them in and bolt them up. But it was much easier to just remove the pans and the tanks all in one, and then we can deal with it later instead of doing that inside the tank. So awesome. You guys are doing a great job. Good job. Keep it up. This is the deal. It's cold outside, like a little too cold for my comfort. But we need to take these tanks off on this air drill. But this side here is being taken up by this air drill, and you have tanks and everything else over there. So what we've decided is we're gonna go ahead and leave this one here, get that one wrapped up so we can get the tanks back in it. Take this one outside, pull the tanks out of it, leave the tanks outside for the time being so we can prep the surface, get everything ready, paint what we need to get that rust to stop rusting. And then when we get those tanks back into it, move that one over here and probably put the crane on the other side and then so forth. At least that's the plan. We will see though. But this means we have to go outside and get a little chilly. So I guess now the plan is we're gonna roll the 3850 out the door. It's sorry, it pulled the tanks off. In order to do that, leg arm's gotta get the skid steer around so I can hook on the front of this. Because on this side of the shop, we just don't have the clearance to use the crane in here. So we gotta do it outside. It is cold out there too, so that's gonna be fun. So let's get this thing out, take the tanks off, bring it back in. Meanwhile, the 4350 is gonna keep getting work done. So hopefully soon they'll be able to get, you know, stuff on it. All right, 4350 cart has its first plenum. What's it called, plenum? Plenum? Not plenum. What's
cradle.
It?
We call it a
cradle.
Cradle.
Stainless steel cradles in. So I put some nice direct metal Rust-Oleum paint across these things. That way hopefully it'll prolong the life and surface rust won't happen for a while. They just put the new stainless steel cradle in with seals all around. That one, tanks are off. Same thing, painted it.
That is stainless steel.
Ooh. They do those from the factory, don't they?
They should.
Yes, they should.
They do not.
But then it would cost another $15,000.
That would be an upcharge, yes.
Anyways, with that said, we're making progress.
So out here we have the poly tanks that we pulled out of the cart number two, we're calling it the smaller cart. And I'm gonna show you the corrosion here. You're gonna see that entire pieces are coming off, and the metal's a lot thinner than it was.
Yeah, look at that. So anyway, we're gonna get those changed. Those are obvious that they need to be replaced. We've got air leaks happening in here. Just really tough. And this one was a seed tank. This one was actually in pretty good shape. You can see that we've had to torch some bolts, but for the most part, all these would come out. And they would have been fine leaving it in there, but it's not that much more to change them while we're in there. It's a ton of work to do it later. And so for like $1,500 more, and some other parts, you can get that all changed. And the labor is a little bit more. And so we decided it was worth doing, so it's all done. And we don't have to worry about it in the future, especially if they decide to use that for fertilizer, or this becomes a fertilizer rig in the future. All right, let's get going.
I am trying to take this connector off of here, but there's a kernel of wheat stuck in behind the latch.
Who puts wheat in these things?
Darn wheat.
Who would do such?
Farmers. They're just...
Why would there be wheat in this tank?
Yeah, what's their deal?
Actually, why would there be? Isn't this the fertilizer tank?
Sometimes we, it depends what we're doing.
Double down, maybe?
Yeah, sometimes we'll just do one tank fertilizer. Usually we do dual, back and middle and then, but there's been times we filled the middle with.
Do you need a heater so you're comfortable?
Yeah, well, that would be nice.
Looks like it's like ice fishing or something.
I'm told by the guys that we're ready for one tank. So we're gonna fire up. We're gonna put the rear tank in first because the way assembling this thing, it's easier, they're thinking, from starting from the back to the front, which means we'll put the rear tank in. And then we got to pull the whole thing outside and do the other two tanks because, well, we don't have enough room in here to do the front two. So let's get to work. Let's get this tank in there. All right, first tank's on. We've got Jesse inside and he is getting ready to put some bolts through. So they got some shiny ones right there. And then we get her all secured. And then I think then we got to take this whole thing out.
It is day three. Spirits are still high. Rations are getting down. We're starting to get scurvy, which is not a good thing, but to solve that issue, we have cherry and strawberry flavored donuts here, which, well, fruit should help this scurvy, so we'll see how it goes. Yeah, I don't think scurvy's gonna be a problem.
We're on the 3850 cart. They got the tanks inside. This thing's painted and pretty much ready to go. As you can see, they already have one installed right here. So that's good. We're getting close to putting a tank in that. I know the other guys are working at installing the tanks on the 4350. It's just painstakingly slow. It's a lot of work, a lot of work. It's like pulling an engine out of a car, overhauling and putting it back in. It's just tedious, but the end result is gonna basically be a bulletproofed air cart that should last a long time. Let's go inside and get to work. So they decided they were short a few pieces. After looking closer at these drills, because they had never seen them in person prior to this, I sent them pictures. And they forgot some tools back home. They had those shit too. These guys are on top of it.
Okay, after a little bit of, getting that tank secure, it is ready to install another tank. So we're gonna pull this thing, or actually push. Yeah, we're gonna push it out. Skid steer, push it out, use the crane outside so we can lift it on top because the crane cannot get over that tank inside the building because it's not tall enough. Somebody, Welker Farms, did not build a big enough shop. My bad. Actually, that's probably my bad. But anyways, I'm gonna get the door for him. He's gonna pull it out, and let's get that other tank in. It is day four. Well, there's still more to do, like a lot more to do. Ran into a couple snares every once in a while. You know, you gotta figure out a couple things, how it goes together and how you do it right. But overall, it's pretty good. Just taking a little longer than we thought. And we should get a lot done today. I hope, at least.
Both those tanks on that thing are in, bolted down. It takes a lot of work to bolt them down. One or two guys got to get inside the tank and feed bolts through while the other guys underneath tightening, and it's just kind of awkward in there because it's not very flat. So, but we're gonna go to the other air drill cart now. I'm gonna drive the scissor lift over and we're gonna do that one because that tank's on too. Maybe we'll call it a night, I don't know.
running out of time. We're gonna try this done by tomorrow. It's gonna be a crunch.
All right, I am inside one of the tanks. I am a lone survivor.
There is molted
bolts that are stuck and fused to the tank when we cut them out with a plasma cutter.
Let's start putting some bolts together this thing.
So, this is taking longer than it should. You guys are probably wondering why it's taking long when I got this awesome Milwaukee M18 Red Lithium CP 2.0. That's not even mine, it's theirs. But we can't use it because these are stainless steel bolts and nuts, and I guess they like to lock up if you have an impact on them. So you gotta hand tighten them nice and slow. And so we put anti-seize before we put the nut on so that it doesn't fuse, because but the reason for doing stainless steel is no more rust.
Okay.
All right, all done.
Up the ladder. Here we go. How do I do this? And fresh air. Okay. Let's see. Sweatshirt out. That's it. 9:30 p.m. Time to go to bed. We'll pick this up tomorrow. See you then. So, last tank on the 4350. I think we're ready to go. Run it out, drop the tank on it, and then run it back in, and then we might do the second one if it's ready. Ready? That's their name, Ready. Ready, Red Engineering. Has absolutely everything to do with the red hair. It's pretty awesome. I like how they embrace it. Put a tank on. Hey, Nick, get in there. You're good at it. You're the man. You can do it. Great.
Go ahead.
Okay. And like that, it's done. I'm out of here.
We are there. The 4350 air cart is ready for the manifold. Ta-da! Looks like Santa's sleigh.
Is that big sweet looking?
That baby's going up underneath here. No more holes, no more leaks. It's gonna be one slick solid setup. That stainless steel is hard. It's not gonna wear holes. It's not gonna corrode fertilizer. Bring it. Put this on. All right, now we got the manifold attached to the 4350 cart. Leg arm's got the kitty bobcat deer hooked up to the cart with the hydraulics. And we're gonna use the pump on that to run this, because that's the closest hydraulics we have, to lift that up. Because then there's a whole bunch of adjusting to make sure it fits tight against the meter rollers, correct?
Meter runners?
Meter housing.
Meter houses.
Meter houses.
Okay, let's lift it.
Let me lift this up first. Ah, there. I've wanted it up for a while now. Where's all this dust coming from? We do have some hydraulic lines in that back corner over there that we need to get tied up a little better. Oh, we're leaking hydraulic oil here. That hose that got stretched, I think she's dripping.
Ready to the rescue.
Yeah. All right.
That wasn't really useful.
There's another leak over there. That's the other end that got stretched. There are leaks all over the place.
Oh, good shot. Ready to the rescue.
All right.
Good job, guys. Good job. That looks really, really slick underneath there. Seriously. Ready? You guys are awesome. Seriously, thank you so much. Appreciate everything you guys have done.
Yeah.
And if you guys are looking for stainless steel stuff, I think they might have a few items.
We got you covered.
All right, team. Good job. Good job.
Yeah.
Good job. Good job. Woo. Good job. You're okay. Good job.
Am I fired?
Well, no.
Oh,
not today. Not today.
I don't want to be fired now.
Thank you, Team Red.
You know what?
Again, Red Engineering. Right?
Yeah.
Ready.
Ready.
So, yes. Jesse, Adam, and what was your name again?
Red.
Oh, Red. That's right. Yeah. And Matt. They were a pleasure to work with. It's been a lot of fun. We hammered these things out. It was definitely a lot of work. And you guys are ready to equip more of these on other flex coil carts someday?
We'll sell you the parts.
Yeah. Oh, there we go. That's okay. But you guys got how-to videos, right?
Yeah, we're working on it.
So, all right. Well, thanks for watching. Drive safe, guys. It's been a pleasure. Until the next time, we'll do something. But we'll catch you guys later. God bless. Later.
3, 2, 1.